हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड क्लास 6 सिविक्स लेसन 2 डाइवर्सिटी एंड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. दीज आर टू न्यू वर्ड्स फॉर यू एंड यू विल गेट द आंसर एंड मीनिंग्स ऑफ दिस वर्ड्स इन द कमिंग स्लाइड्स. सो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस लेसन आर डिफरेंस एंड प्रीजुडाइस. ओके, हाउ टू प्रोनाउंस prejudice. Next is creating stereotype. Stereotype. Next is discrimination. And the next is serving for equality. So these are very, I think you people have heard these terms for the first time. So very heavy words and very heavy meaning as well, and very serious topic. Examples of diversity in India. Let us first know what diversity is. Diversity means different, various, different types of. There are 8 major religions in the world, and followers of all these religions are found in India. How good for India, hai na? See, all over the world, 8 major religions, but those all major 8 religions, they are found in India. See, the maximum number of people around the world, they are Christian. They are 34%. Thereafter, 25% Muslims in the world. 16% are Hindu in the world. 12 are agnostic. 6 are Buddhist. 7 are other religions. So this is the percentage of religions in the world, not in the India. But these all religions, they are found in India itself. So we people are so lucky that we have almost all types of religions in our country, because we can get the holidays for all these religions. We will get Christmas holiday, we will get Eid ul Juha holiday, and for Hindus, Holi, Diwali, everything. There are a lot of festivals in Hinduism also, and Buddhism also, they have Buddha Purnima. Sikh also, we have Baisakhi and Lohri. So in India, we can get lot of holidays, and we can understand various customs and traditions of these religions from their people. There are more than 1600 languages and even more dialects being spoken in India. Dialects means regional languages, means which are spoken in very small area. So see, in languages also we are very rich. We means we Indians. In many countries, they have only one language, that is English, or they have one language, German, Spanish, Chinese. But in India, we have Hindi, Bengali, Odia, Tamil, Kannad, Malayalam, Punjabi, Haryanvi, Nepali, right? So we have lot of languages in India. There are more than 100 dance forms in India. If we talk about Japan, they have one dance that is known as Japanese. If we talk about Spain, they have a Spanish dance. But in India, we have Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, Manipuri, Odissi, Kathak, Kuchipudi, Mohini Attam, Garba, Bhangra. Right? So we have lot of dance forms also. There are more than 100 dance forms in India. As you can see, this is the dance form of Japan. So they have only one dance form. This is dance of Africa. They are only having one dance form. This is dance form of Japan. There are many styles of mural paintings in different parts of India. See, these are some of the examples of the painting which are being done in India. Now the term is prejudice. What it means? Sometime when we meet people who are different from us, we may find them strange and unfamiliar. For us, suppose we have seen one person from South India, or you can say one person from Africa, because they are sometime very dark complexion, they are dark in color, so we will get some scare from them. But they are also very nice human being, just like us. People also from certain attitudes and opinion about others who are not like them. Because we will see that some people have different style of clothing. In European countries and in many of the countries, you will see that people wear variety of clothes, and we will again watch them from top to bottom because we don't wear such clothes. But that is their natural dress, right? They feel comfortable in those dresses. So just because we don't wear such clothes doesn't mean they are different from us. They are also like us. And sometime in India, we feel that some other tourists, if they will come to India from other country, when they will see our sari, they will also feel strange about us. Oh, see this Indian woman, how much she is draping and covering herself from this long cloth known as sari. So for us also, our dress is strange for the other country people, the way other countries' dress is strange for us. On rural people, let us do the comparison between village and town. What we think that more than 50% of Indian, they live in villages. And what people think about villagers are that villagers do not care about their health, right? They eat anything, they are not hygienic, they don't wash their hands and they don't take bath. They are full of superstitions. They believe anything. People in villages are backward and they do not use modern agricultural technologies. This is what we think about the village people. On rural people, more than in peak harvesting and planting seasons, families spend 12 to 14 hours working in fields. Villagers are forced to migrate to cities in search of work. Because in village they don't get any job, so they come to cities for the work. Now, what do other people think about cities? What do the people of villages or other people, they think about the people who live in city? What they think that life in the city is very easy. What they think that people of city, they are very spoiled, they don't do anything and they are very lazy. In cities, families spend very less time with their children. People in cities, they only care about money. And people in cities are living in cities expensive. Means if you have lot of money, then only you can live in city. So these are some of the views we have about the city people. But you can see that Tiger Woods, he is the top golf player of America. When we think that superstitions, means andhavishwas, are only found in the village people, it is not correct. Tiger Woods also has one superstition. What is it? He always wears red and black during the final round of every tournament he plays. So what is it? This is also one type of superstition, and that too when he is from city, and that too from he is from such a country where everybody is educated and having a lot of money. So superstition can be found in cities also. Amitabh Bachchan, he avoids watching cricket matches when India plays because what he thinks when he will play, India will lose the match. So Amitabh Bachchan also has a superstition. And Salman Khan, he always wears this bracelet of him which is given to him by his father. And by wearing this bracelet, he thinks his all films will get hit. And this is a picture of Ratan Tata. Lot of people think the people of cities, they are very cruel, they are very selfish, they are very miser, they don't spend money. But recently during the coronavirus epidemic, he had donated 1500 crore rupees to Prime Minister Care Fund. So how can you call him miser? How can you call him selfish? He is such a generous and kind person. he is a rich person, but still he is very kind person. Next, this picture is of a village boy who used to sell teas at the railway station in Gujarat, and he comes from a very humble and very poor family in Gujarat. And after lot of effort, lot of hard work, he has reached the top position of Indian government, that is Prime Minister of India. He is Narendra Modi. So how can you say that a village person, village boy cannot become a great person in country? So these are the superstition, these are the beliefs which you have about the village life and the city lives can be wrong. And this is also one person, he is from Bihar, Anand Kumar Srivastav. So he has also opened one institution known as Super 30, where he teaches all the poor students of the Bihar who become engineers after getting coaching from this person. So what prejudice is? When someone judges another person in a negative way. Prejudice is not a positive word, it's a negative word. जब हम दूसरों के बारे में ऐसे सोचते हैं, अरे ये तो साउथ इंडियन है तो ये काला होगा, ये गांव का आदमी है तो ये गंवार होगा, ये शहर का आदमी है तो ये बहुत चालाक होगा, ये लड़की है तो ये कमजोर होगी, ये पहलवान है तो ये ताकत होगा. जब हम ऑलरेडी किसी के बारे में सोच लेते हैं तो दैट इज नोन एज प्रिजुडाइस. कभी कभी पहलवान भी बहुत डरपोक हो सकते हैं, राइट. कभी कभी शहर के लोग भी बहुत काइंड हो सकते हैं और गांव के लोग चालाक हो सकते हैं. सो प्रिजुडाइस ऑफन हैव सर्टन प्रिजुडाइस अबाउट अदर पीपल हु मे अपीयर डिफरेंट. लाइक हमको गाँव वाले हमेशा गंवार लगते हैं, बट ऐसा नहीं होता है. हमको लगता है गांव बहुत गंदे होते हैं, बट ऐसा नहीं है. यू कैन सी दिस विलेज, हाउ क्लीन एंड नीट दिस विलेज इज. इनफैक्ट आई हैव सीन लॉट ऑफ गार्बेज इन सिटीज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू थिंक इंग्लिश इज द बेस्ट लैंग्वेज एंड अदर लैंग्वेजेस आर नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, वी आर जजिंग दैट दीज अदर लैंग्वेजेस नेगेटिवली. As you can see, this is one of the village in Uttar Pradesh which has given 53 IAS officers. So each house of this village is having one child who has become the IAS officer in UP. So just by thinking that the people of villages are very backward is prejudice. And just thinking that the people of cities, they speak good English, they are very learned, they are very disciplined, mannerful, that is also wrong. These are the three people who have taken lot of money from Indian banks. They have done a scam. वो इंडिया से पैसे लेके भाग गए. So शहर के पढ़े लिखे लोग भी तो चोर और जो है फ्रॉड हो सकते हैं. We can be prejudiced about many things, people's religious beliefs, the color of their skin, the region they come from, the accent they speak and the clothes they wear. हमको लगता है जितने भी small eyes लोग होते हैं, they all are Chinese, Japanese and Nepalese. But ऐसा नहीं है. हमारे नॉर्थ ईस्ट में there are seven states and those people also have the small eyes, but they are not Nepalese or Chinese, they are Indian. So we need to change our thinking, right? This is Baiching Bhutia. People when see him, they know that he is from some other country, but no, he is 100% Indian. So you need to know all the regions of your country first, then you speak something. And when you speak something, you should know about it. And what we think that all the black skinned people, they are not beautiful, but it is not correct. People of black skin, they are also very beautiful, just like the fair skinned people. In fact, sometimes fair skinned people, they don't have the good features like the dark complexion people. And sometimes people think the people of Bihar, they are always illiterate. But that is also not correct because the most IAS and IPS officer of India, they are from Bihar. Next word is disabled. The children you see in these pictures, they are known as disabled. Disabled means they are not able to do few of the work. This boy, this small tiny boy or girl, whosoever, she or he is unable to walk properly. And this boy also, he is unable to walk properly. So sometime what happens, other students and other people of the nearby areas, they make fun of it. So please don't do. Whenever you see such types of people, have sympathy with them. Just think them as like yourself. Now disabled word is not used for them. Now we call them children with special needs. Okay, next is how do we create stereotype? Comparison. These are some of the sentences which are being spoken for the genders, means either for boys or for girls. They are well behaved. Whenever we say this sentence, this is spoken for girls. Why everybody thinks that girls should be well behaved? Why don't they think that boys should also be well behaved? Next, they are soft spoken and gentle. This again is considered for girls. Why don't you teach your sons to be gentle and soft spoken? They are physically strong. This is said always for the boys. Why can't be girls physically strong? Girls can also be the physically strong. Next is they are naughty, they are good. This is again said for the boys. Why can't be a girl naughty? Girls also look pretty when they do some mischiefs. जब शरारतें करती हैं तो बेटा हो या बेटी दोनों अच्छे लगते हैं. They don't cry. Who don't cry? Most often this is said for boys. Why can't they cry? Boys also have emotions. Let them also cry, because whenever some boys start crying, his friends start making fun of him. It's not like that. लड़कों को भी रोना चाहिए, अपने इमोशंस को बाहर निकालना चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर आप अपने इमोशंस को अपने अंदर ही दबा के रखोगे, देन व्हाट विल हैपन बेटा, यू विल गेट डिप्रेस्ड. आप अंदर ही अंदर जो है डिप्रेशन के विक्टिम बन जाओगे. एंड रिसेंटली यू हैव सीन सुशांत सिंह राजपूत्स केस. ही वॉज ऑल्सो अ बॉय. ही कुड नॉट टेल वॉट ही वॉज फीलिंग इनसाइड. ही कुड नॉट क्राई एंड फाइनली ही अटेम्प्टेड सुसाइड. सो बॉय हो चाहे गर्ल हो, अगर आपको बुरा लग रहा है किसी चीज़ के बारे में, तो यू मस्ट क्राई, यू मस्ट स्पीक, यू मस्ट शेयर इट विद समबडी. आपको रोना आ रहा है तो पक्का रोना चाहिए. अपने आंसुओं को अंदर दबाने से आप बीमार हो सकते हो. तो बॉयज़ को भी रोने देना चाहिए, गर्ल्स को भी रोने देना चाहिए. दे आर राउडी. दिस इज सेट फॉर बॉयज. दे आर गुड एट स्पोर्ट्स. Why only boys? Nowadays girls as well as boys, they both are good at sports. तो जब भी हम ये sentence बोले तो हम boys के लिए क्यों बोले? We should speak the sentence for girls also. They are good at cooking. Who are girls good at cooking? Most of the time people say this for girls. But you have seen in most of the hotels, all the big and famous chefs are boys. देखा नहीं आपने कितने बड़े बड़े होटलों में, या यूट्यूब में देख लो या टीवी में शो में देख लो, जितने भी बड़े बड़े शेफ्स होते हैं वो बॉयज़ होते हैं. तो बॉयज़ भी गर्ल्स से बहुत बढ़िया और टेस्टी खाना बना सकते हैं. तो वाई शुड ओनली गर्ल्स नीड टू लर्न कुक? बॉयज़ शुड ऑल्सो लर्न टू कुक. दे आर इमोशनल. बोथ शुड बी इमोशनल. बॉयज़ को भी इमोशनल होना चाहिए और गर्ल्स को भी इमोशनल होना चाहिए. When we fix people into one image, we create stereotype. Are you getting my point? जब हमको लगता है कि इसका काम यही है, तो it means we are creating stereotype. जब भी लड़का लड़की देखने जाता है तो लड़की चाय लेके आती है, तो हमको लगता है कि चाय लाना लड़की का ही काम है. पर ऐसा हमेशा क्यों हो? लड़की को भी तो लड़का देखने जाना चाहिए, और कभी कभी लड़के को भी तो सर्व करना चाहिए चाय, क्योंकि दोनों को एक दूसरे के साथ शादी करनी है, दोनों की एक दूसरे के साथ जो है पसंद होनी चाहिए. सो दिस स्टीरियोटाइप शुड बी स्टॉप्ड. both should serve tea to each other. Why always girls should serve the tea? This stereotype should be broken. A common stereotype about Muslim is that they are not interested in educating girls and therefore do not send girls to schools. Most of the people in India, they think that people of Muslim community, they don't send their girls, their daughters to school. But this is also not correct. How come? You can see the example of Kerala. In Kerala, the distance between the school and the home is not much. Government bus service that helps teachers to reach school in rural areas, and over 60% of the teachers are women in Kerala, and you know there is majority of the population is Muslim in Kerala. So it means Kerala mein to sari ladkiyan padhi likhi hain, Muslim ladkiyan. To hum ye kaise bol sakte hain ki Muslim log apni ladkiyon ko nahi padhate hain? It's not because they are Muslim, it's because sometimes they are poor, so they don't send their daughters to school. Now next is Dalit. What is Dalit? Dalit is a term that people belonging to so-called lower caste used to address themselves. जितने भी lower caste वाले लोग होते हैं वो अपने आप के लिए Dalit use करते हैं, and Dalit means untouchable or broken. Indian society में lower caste वाले लोग के साथ जो है बहुत भेदभाव discrimination किया जाता है. Untouchables are forced to pick garbage and remove dead animals from the village. But they were not allowed to enter the homes of upper caste people to take water from the village or even enter the temples. Their children could not sit next to children of other caste in school. As you can see in this picture, these black dotted pictures, they both are Dalit children, so they are sitting behind the upper caste children. Stereotypes affect all of us. Agar hamare saath koi aise discrimination kare, if somebody will make us sit behind all the students in the class and teacher will not give us benches in the school or in the classroom to sit, how bad we will feel. Will not go to school from the next day. Main to next day se school hi jana chhod dungi. Right? So, कितना बुरा लगता होगा ऐसे टाइम पे बच्चों को जब आप जो है बाकी बच्चों को बैठने के लिए बेंच प्रोवाइड करते हो और दलित बच्चों को आप जमीन पे बिठाते हो. ये उन बच्चों को बहुत बुरी तरह से हर्ट करता है. सो इट शुड नॉट हैपन इन एनी कंडीशन और एनी स्कूल इन इंडिया. एंड समटाइम्स स्टीरियोटाइप्स मीन्स व्हाई ओनली गर्ल्स आर लुकिंग आफ्टर देयर यंगर सिबलिंग्स. हमेशा जो होती है एक जो बेटी होती है वो ही अपने छोटे भाई बहनों को लुक आफ्टर क्यों करती है. हम अपने घर में अपने बेटों को क्यों नहीं रखते हैं अपने छोटे भाई बहनों को देखने के लिए. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो स्टीरियोटाइप, वी शुड ब्रेक इट. एज यू कैन सी दीज वेरी फेमस पर्सनैलिटीज, दे ऑल वर वुमेन, एंड हाउ फेमस एंड हाउ स्ट्रॉन्ग लीडर्स दे वर. तो ऐसा कौन बोलता है गर्ल्स कैन नॉट वर्क ऑन द बिग पोजिशंस. Next words are inequality and discrimination. When someone acts on the basis of the prejudices, this act may result in discrimination. Discrimination means stopping someone from certain facility. Like if you're sending a boy to school and not sending girl to school, that is discrimination. Discrimination is based on various differences. Those are on the basis of religion, on the basis of gender, on the basis of caste, on the basis of regional. That is known as discrimination. We will read about them in this video. See, first is gender based discrimination. A girl is not allowed to go to school beyond 5 or 6 class is also an example of discrimination. Most of the girls are not allowed to select a career of their choice and they are forced into marriage. Boys ko to hum marriage karne ke liye force nahi karte, unko to bolte hain beta jao naukri dhoondo. But girls ko bolte hain nahi teri shaadi karni hai. Hum girls ko bhi naukri dhoondne ke liye bolenge na. बॉयज़ को भी अगर शादी, गर्ल्स को शादी के लिए फोर्स कर रहे हैं तो हम बॉय को भी शादी के लिए फोर्स करें, बट अगर हम बॉय को नौकरी के लिए बोल रहे हैं, गर्ल्स को शादी के लिए बोल रहे हैं, तो दैट इज़ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। आप भेदभाव कर रहे हो, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन मीन्स भेदभाव। इन सम फैमिलीज गर्ल्स आर नॉट अलाउड टू वियर वेस्टर्न ड्रेसेस वाइल बॉयज़ इन सच फैमिलीज ऑफन वियर वेस्टर्न ड्रेसेस। बॉयज़ तो कोट पैंट और जीन्स पहन के घूमता है, बट हमारी गर्ल्स जो है अगर वेस्टर्न ड्रेसेस जीन्स और टी शर्ट पहनती है तो हमारे पेरेंट्स उनको अलाउ नहीं करते। तो गर्ल्स को बोलते हैं आप इंडियन ड्रेसेस पहनो, साड़ी पहनो, सूट पहनो, तो आप बॉयज़ को भी बोलो ना आप धोती और कुर्ता पहनो, आप उनको पैंट और जीन्स क्यों पहना रहे हो। जब आप बॉयज़ को वेस्टर्न ड्रेस अलाउ कर रहे हो तो यू शुड अलाउ वेस्टर्न ड्रेसेस टू गर्ल्स ऑल्सो। नेक्स्ट इज रिलीजन बेस्ड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। जब हम किसी के रिलीजन के आधार पे उनसे डिस्क्रिमिनेशन करते हैं, अ पर्सन डज नॉट गेट अ जॉब ओनली बिकॉज ही बिलोंग्स टू अ पर्टिकुलर रिलीजन। सपोज आई हैव अ स्कूल एंड आई वॉन्ट अ संस्कृत टीचर, I got one person from Muslim background and he is very good in Sanskrit, but I don't keep him on job because I feel that Sanskrit should be taught by a Hindu person only. So this is discrimination. Sanskrit पढ़ाने के लिए मैं केवल हिंदू टीचर क्यों रखूँ? अगर संस्कृत कोई भी पढ़ा सकता है तो वो मुस्लिम टीचर भी हो सकता है, वो सिख टीचर भी हो सकता है। तो this is also example of discrimination. A person of other religion is not allowed to enter the temple. Suppose there is some Christian or Muslim, we don't allow him to enter our temple, so that is discrimination. And similarly, a Muslim community or a Christian community does not allow a Hindu to enter their mosque or church, that is also discrimination. Next is caste based discrimination. You know, in Hindu mythology we have four castes: Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Sabka alag alag kaam hai. Brahman is supposed to do worship. Kshatriya is supposed to rule the country or do wars. Vaishya is supposed to do business, and Shudras are supposed to do all the small works like cleaning, doing the maid job, doing the assistant job. There is one community known as Mahar. This is an untouchable community of Maharashtra, and they were supposed to clean the village area, garbage, and clear dead animals from the villages. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he also belonged to the Mahar caste of Maharashtra, and he had also suffered lot of discrimination during his childhood. Dr. Ambedkar was the first person from his Mahar caste who had completed his college education. Then he went to England to become a lawyer. Next is religion-based discrimination. Sorry, this is also caste-based discrimination. In many villages in India, even now, lower caste people are not supposed to take water from the wells of the upper caste. So this is one example of a person who is from the Dalit community. He did a mistake to take water from the well of the upper caste community. So what he faced, he was badly beaten by the upper caste people, and he was warned not to come again to the upper caste people's well. The son of a cobbler could only become a cobbler and nothing else. This is what the people think. The task of conducting all the religious rituals will be done only by the Brahmin. This is discrimination. A person from lower caste people cannot eat with the Brahmins. This is the picture of Vinod Kambli. He was a very good cricketer. He was a very good friend of Sachin Tendulkar also, and but he is also from Dalit community of Maharashtra. But as you can see, your talent is not dependent on your caste. This is a picture of Ramnath Kovind. He is again from a Dalit community, but see, with his talent, he has reached the top position of India, that is President of India. And now, all Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, they are always around him to follow his order. So, when you have talent, no one can stop you from getting top positions. And this is the picture of Rajkumar Rao, and you have seen many of his movies. He is such a talented actor, but he belongs to a Dalit community in Haryana. But talent is not dependent again on your caste. If you are good, audience will love your acting. They will not look for your caste. Striving for equality, Gandhiji coined the term Harijan for those from the untouchable caste. Dalit logon ko Gandhiji ne Harijan naam diya. Harijan ka matlab hota hai, Hari means Bhagwan, Jan means log, Bhagwan ke log, the people of God. He did a great deal of work in removing prejudices from people's mind. उन्होंने भी जो है दलित कास्ट के लोगों के लिए बहुत वेलफेयर काम किया. ही यूज़ टू गो टू देयर हर्ट्स, ही यूज़ टू ईट विद देम, ही यूज़ टू सिट विद देम. बी आर अम्बेडकर वॉज अनदर लीडिंग फिगर हु फाउट अगेंस्ट कास्ट बेस्ड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. सो दीज आर टू पीपल हु हैड वर्कड अ लॉट फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ द अनटचेबल्स और द दलित पीपल. The Constitution of India has made several provisions for improving the condition of the downtrodden, means lower caste people. When India became free in 1947, Constitution declared India as a secular country. You know, secular means without any religion. India does not has any religion of its official, means India will treat all the religions equally. This is the Constitution of India. If you read it, you will find that everybody, upper caste, lower caste, Hindu, Muslim, boy, girl, all are equal before the law. Nobody can discriminate them on the basis of any gender, caste, religion, or color. These are some important questions related to this lesson. As you have read all the lesson, you can make the answer or you can find the answer by going back and watching the video again. So scroll and pause the video at the questions and try to give the answers on your own. This is second set of questions, very important questions I have compiled for you. Next set of questions. So thank you for today. Please do like, subscribe for more good videos. Our channel, that is Wow Education.